Today, we go over the first 10 projects we did on the K40 laser cutter. Number 1. The simple thing is to get some clip art from the web and convert it with Inkscape into an outline. We will link to this and all other graphics in the written article on our website. We cut this outline from a simple sheet of colored print paper and have a nice decorative element to put in one of the windows. Number 2. Let's stick for a moment with the paper and use Inkscape to modify a clip art such as this elephant to create a series of open lines. If you're interested in a more detailed video on this or any other of the topics, please leave a comment. If we cut this shape in a sheet of paper, we create a cute little pop-up card. Number 3. After cutting paper, cardboard is the next step. When we connect the internal parts of the Way of Wood logo with the rest of the page, we can cut a fairly complex stencil. After cutting it, we could start to put logo stencils all over the workshop. Number 4. Our kids got a shadow play game for Christmas, but the game was missing a few important figures. So we got a decent amount of knights, dragons and other clip arts. With the software deepnest.io, we packed them tightly on some cardboard and cut them out. A dab of hot glue and a skewer make a great shadow play figure. Number 5. The next thing is still from cardboard, but a bit more functional. From old Amazon packages, we cut the same shape several times. After gluing the layers together, we get a nice protective cover for a portable hard drive. Number 6. This cardboard insert obviously needs a box. We use a box configurator to create a finger-jointed box. After some modifications in Inkscape and adding an engraving, we cut the box on the laser. Now only a little glue and the box is done and will protect our backup hard drive going forward. Number 7. Cutting these little boxes from plywood is great for organizing stuff. With two of these boxes cut and glued together, we finally have a place for the zip ties at the workbench. MDF is even better to create boxes. Here are some flash cord holders for the kits that we made in Inkscape with some minor modifications of a ready-made box design. Number 8. It's nice that the laser can cut quickly a large amount of small holes. That is exactly what's necessary to create a small tool organizer. We created a pattern of different sized holes in Inkscape and cut it twice on the laser. The two side pieces are made from solid wood. They get grooves parallel to the edge on the table saw and are then cut at an angle on the bandsaw. After a few strokes with the plane, the parts can be glued together. The organizers hang on the wall over the electronics tinkering and 3D printing area. We put all kind of modeling tools, small files, knives and other small parts in it. Number 9. Now something completely different. We use a special font from Steve Gott's website to create a simple keychain. The keychain is cut twice so that the lower half can house a small magnet. We then attach one side to the key, and with the other side, we can attach the keychain to a metal surface. Number 10. So far, all the materials were readily available at the home center or the craft store. For this one, we ordered some 6mm acrylic on eBay. We put our SodaStream appliance on a scanner to trace its bottom. We then add a 10mm border and cut two shapes. First, the inner and the outer line, and then, from some thinner material, only the outer perimeter. We glue the two pieces and four small feet together and have a perfectly fitted stand. It's a lot of fun to play around with the laser. Before jumping into a project, have a look at our other videos for some important safety upgrades. Also, don't forget to subscribe and follow us on Instagram for a look at future projects.